Hello everybody, Tegan here with High Point. Thank you so much for tuning in. William Optics just announced the release of a brand new series of refractor. It's their Pleiades refractors, and these are not doublets, they're not triplets, they're not quintuplets. These are septuplet refractors with seven optical elements. They've announced a 68 millimeter and a 111 millimeter. Let's talk about them. All right, so here we have the manual for the Pleiades 68. There's a lot to unpack here. Let's go ahead and talk about specifications. So first off, we have a focal length of 260 millimeters, aperture diameter of 68 millimeters, and a focal ratio of f3.8. This scope does come included with the WIFD, or the internal focus design that you're now seeing William Optics put on their new refractors. The imaging circle is compatible with full frame cameras. That is a 45 millimeter imaging circle. And another important factor is the weight down here. The weight with everything included, the OTA, the rings, the dovetail, and the saddle, come in at 8.45 pounds. So as far as the specifications for the new 111 millimeter Pleiades refractor, keep an eye out on our website for more information. We don't have all the information yet from William Optics, but we do know that it's going to be longer focal length than the 68 millimeter, and the focal ratio is going to be f4.8, and it's going to have a 111 millimeter objective. Okay, so if we move down to the next page, there's a nice note here from William Optics. They do have a new lens cell design in the William Optics Pleiades series telescope, and they just want to let you know that before storing your telescope, it is crucial to allow it sufficient time to acclimate to room temperature. So all William Optics wants you to know here is that with this new lens cell design, it is important to keep your refractor dry. To maintain the quality and assure the safety of the internal parts, you need to make sure when you bring it in and put it into storage that there is no dew or condensation on the inside or the outside of the scope. What we recommend is that if you are bringing it in from a cold environment, wrap it in a towel and slowly let it warm up to ambient room temperature. When it's finished, then you can pack it away in your carrying case, and you don't have to worry about dew or condensation settling on the optics or inside or outside the telescope. All right, if we move on down here, page 4, we have an important note on back focus. If you see here, it says 55 millimeters, which is great, standard back focus. Have a T-ring with your DSLR or your mirrorless camera. That'll bring you to 55 millimeters, or the standard spacers that come with the ZWO cameras. That will also bring you to 55 millimeters, so nothing new here. And down here, they have M48 and M54 camera threads. Moving on down to the package contents, we have the William Optics scope itself. It comes with a dust cover, with the integrated Batinov mask. We have a dew shield. We have the main optical tube, a 120 millimeter handlebar. We have a camera angle rotation device. We have also a tilt adapter integrated in here, and we will talk about that in a moment as well. We have a Vixen style dovetail, and again, M48 and M54 camera threads on the back, and of course the soft carrying case has a nice little alien here in the O, and the beautiful Pleiades star cluster, or the seven sisters here, printed on the front of the soft case. Now moving on down, again, we talked a little bit about parts. It does have a nice dual speed focuser and a retractable dew shield as well. Integrated into the dust cap is this Batinov mask, and it's clear, which means you're going to get very nice diffraction patterns on some very dim stars. Again, you have the hexagonal ring set here that holds the dovetail and the mounting bar on top. All right, now moving on down, we have some more information about the telescope itself. Again, 10-to-1 ratio design, your threads on the back, you have the camera rotator. But here on the back of the focuser, you have tension screws for increased tension, and of course, finder bracket holder screws. You can remove both of these before use. You want to use 5 and 2.5 millimeter Allen keys respectively. Here on the bottom of the focuser, we have some information as to what all of these do. These are push and pull adjustment screws, and this green screw here is for attaching your electronic autofocuser. William Optics recommends that you don't adjust these until you ask William Optics, so we recommend keeping these set unless you want to adjust or install your autofocuser, which we will talk about here in a moment. Now moving down, we have information about the tilt adapter. What you want to do is remove this screw and twist the cover off of the camera rotator or the focus rotator, and inside you will find tilt adjustment knobs. And William Optics has provided a nice guide as to which are push knobs and which are pull knobs. This should help recover and fix any tilt that you may find in your imaging train. And lastly, they have a nice step-by-step guide on how to install the EAF or your electronic autofocuser. Simply remove the coarse adjustment knob, install the bracket, and then install the actual autofocuser itself. All right, so that is all the information that we know so far about the William Optics Pleiades 68 septuplet apochromatic refractor. Again, we don't have too much information on the 111 millimeter version of this telescope, so make sure you keep an eye on our website. We will be sure to put the links to both of these refractors in the description below. If you have any questions, also let us know in the comments and we will be happy to assist. Thank you so much for tuning in, and clear skies.